1935, an experimental station was established at Orford, on the east coast of England. It was there that the early experiments in detecting aircraft were carried out. In those days, the only way to locate an aircraft approaching was visually, or with concrete sound amplifiers. The essential problem was to calculate the range, direction, and height of an approaching aircraft. The first practical installation was built at Bawdsey, where in 1937, the technicians were able to get a three-dimensional fix on incoming aircraft. This was the first fully working radar station in Britain. London was the most vital target to be protected, and the first five stations were built just before the war to cover the Thames estuary. By 1940, the tall lattice masts carrying the antenna guarded most of the coastline of Britain. The system was called Chain Home. Prior to the incoming aircraft, the greater the range of the station. A further range of stations were fitted with radars to detect low-flying intruders, Chain Home Low. In May 1940, the Germans invaded France. Thousands of British and French troops were brought back from the beaches of Dunkirk, which left Britain alone to face the power of Hitler's victorious Luftwaffe. Pilot of this was the Royal Air Force. To guide the fighters towards the German aircraft, the radar stations around the coast located the incoming radars, and the information was passed to the fighter control centers. Constantly updated, each raid was tracked, and the controllers ordered the fighter squadrons to intercept. Duels were fought out in the skies over southern England, and the Luftwaffe paid a heavy price. Success of D-Day. when the greatest amphibious operation of all times began the process of the liberation of Europe. Allied jamming ensured that the huge convoys of shipping approaching the coast of Normandy remained undetected. As German radars that had not been destroyed by bombs were shown by warships. Channel, the enemy radars were persuaded that phantom convoys were heading towards Boulogne. Aircraft flying in an elliptical pattern dropped bundles of window at intervals, which gave the impression of ships to German operators. A similar deception was achieved with small ships towing balloons to give a larger trace. One of the most powerful enemy radars was at Douvres la Delibrande, which could cover the British landing beaches and the Bay of the Seine. Although the antennas had been smashed, the garrison offered a determined resistance on D-Day and did not finally surrender until the 17th of June. When British troops moved in, they were greeted with a scene of utter devastation, half-finished buildings and discarded clothing. They also found a few souvenirs and did their best to make themselves at home. Soldier, once bitter enemies, united in death.